reminiscing on that. I remember they used to give us that free cheese, the big block of that shit. Yo. Man, I'm glad y'all ain't got to get that cheese, man. I thank God my kids ain't got to see that cheese. Yo.
Coming from the place that I'm from, you know, I decided to start this YouTube channel just to kind of show people from similar places, like, some of the things I've been able to see. I'm, like, extremely appreciative. And, you know, just a deep appreciation for the beauty and some of the experiences I've encountered just traveling.
I'm sorry, I don't know much Italian. I'm Sheron.
Quiet, tell my niggas all my aspirations. No more beefing with rappers, it's just murder or nothing. New positions, the master, I perfected the others. Niggas shoot for the magic, never heard of Matumbo. These are lucrative assets, golden words that are mumbled.
Is it down the street? On the right is the arch.
Thank you.
Ciao.
It's lit. We in Sicily. About to be stereotypical and get some Sicilian pizza, but that ain't what we doing. We gotta get some of this pasta. Said there's a restaurant called Tiramisu. Let's see what this thing hit. I'm always fascinated by, like, architecture. Like, seeing a building that's 200 years old or 400 years old and knowing that they were, like, hand-constructed, not having certain machinery is always fascinating to me. Anybody that knows me knows I'm extreme. I'm into fragrances. I love smell goods. I probably have over 100 colognes, and my personal favorite is Baccarat Rouge 540. And I bought a new bottle before I hit the road. It was, you know, the large bottle, and somewhere on the road it came up missing, and I'm been extremely frustrated, so I'm happy that I bumped into a place that actually sells it. So I guess I, you know, have to buy myself a new bottle.
So
this one is 310?
No, 310 is the 75.
I can't, but I lost a
whole
bottle.
Easier. Well, I mean, the off-shelf price in Francisco.
Easy part, this one, right?
The big one, 6 ounces, yeah. Except the 25 for the shipping. You know,
I want to buy the big bottle, but I don't want them to try to take it at the airport. And I didn't bring a check bag because we're only here for 2 days. So we got a quick reroute. My man here got a, I like his style. He's saying we got to go to this restaurant down here.
The thing for me, I don't identify as any particular religion, but when I'm traveling, you know, to me a church or a religious place is usually where people come together with a common goal. They want to connect, you know, they're in search of like a higher guidance. And for me, whether I be in a Muslim country or a Christian country or a Buddhist country, I always, you know, I never turn away from them to try to connect with the people and connect with God. I try to experience everything from the highs to the lows, from like food that comes from a food truck to the nicest restaurant in the area. I try to connect with the people, and I think the best way to do that culturally is through like food and music and entertainment. So I asked some of the local people for some recommendations on some restaurants.
And this one here is called gallinella. It's a kind of local rockfish with a white and super soft and buttery meat. That's why it's a fish that needs a lot of salt for the preparation. And it's why the chefs suggest cook in a Sicilian style way. And it's me, just deep ham with organic olive oil from Etna.
This was really one of the most amazing meals I've ever tasted. It was paired with some amazing wine. I think we went from white wine to a rosé. And then I think later in the meal, we shifted to a red wine. Maybe it was a Bordeaux. Really amazing dining experience.
Mm-hmm. Enjoy.
Enjoy.
Taking a stroll, fresh morning fit for the day. Taking a stroll, we in Sicily. Probably gonna eat some pizza. Can't be in Sicily and not try the pizza. In design and my career as a designer and a leather craftsman has really changed my life. Like, fashion really changed my life. It's allowed me to see the world. In the past 5 years, I've probably visited 70 or 80, you know, countries around the world, and I've seen some of the most beautiful things I never thought I'd have an opportunity to see, being a, you know, a person or a kid from America's poorest city. This is Taormina, Sicily. You know, so to be able to like travel the world, have a love for what I do, experience different cultures, eat amazing food, and meet amazing people, I'm just eternally grateful. So I think, you know, these blogs are kind of a celebration of that and trying to share the things I see, because sometimes I feel like, you know, other people should experience the things that I'm seeing. And a lot of the times I'm on the road traveling alone. Maybe it's just me and Naj. I'll catch y'all next episode. Peace.